Hi everyone, today we will do legal dictation exercise number 49. You can get the PDF from description box. So ready? Start. The credit movement in this country started in 1904 and it had its own difficulties since the last several decades. The main problem regarding cooperative credit has been that it has been ultimately an inadequate. In 1904, the Cooperative Societies Act was passed, which was later amended in 1914. Then there were certain committees appointed and they reported about the weakness of the credit movement in the country. In 1919, this subject of cooperation was transferred to the states, after which several states passed cooperative acts of their own. Thereafter, in 1929, the Royal Commission made certain inquiries about cooperative and the credit movement and made certain recommendations. Until 1950 or 1951, there was very little improvement in the field of cooperation. In 1951, the Reserve Bank of India appointed the Rural Credit Survey Committee, which brought out its report in 1954. That committee came to the conclusion that only 3% of the credit required by the agriculturist in the country was being met by the cooperative, and it made certain suggestion. It suggested that there should be an integrated credit structure in the country and said that there should be fair participation by the government in the cooperative societies. It suggested that the government should take shares in the cooperative societies so that the cooperative movement can get strength through government participation. The second recommendation made by the Rural Credit Survey Committee was that there should be linking of credit with marketing, processing, consumer, storage, and all other fields of activity so that credit will develop marketing, consumption, processing, etc. Yet another recommendation was that there should be a training program for the non-official. The fourth recommendation and the most silent one was that there should be a three-tier structure of credit. There should be cooperative societies at the lower level, then there should be district bank and then the apex bank, and that all the three should be interlinked. These recommendations were accepted by the government of India. This report also recommended that in order to implement these suggestions, there should be a national cooperative development and warehousing board. The government of India have accepted these suggestions in 1956. According to that act that came into being, a warehousing board which took care of the warehouse in the country, and also the National Development Board which took care of the development of the cooperative. It was first thought that the two boards should be worked out under two different acts, but as both the subject were administratively under one ministry at that time, namely the Ministry of Food and Agriculture, it was thought proper at that stage that the same act should administer the National Development Board and Warehousing Corporation. Thereafter, a separate Department of Cooperation was created and attached to the Ministry of Community Development, now called the Ministry of Community Development, Panchayati Raj and Cooperation. And it was decided by the government in 1960 that there should be two separate acts, one for Cooperative Development Board and the other for warehousing. In one of the papers submitted by the Ministry of Food and Agriculture, on the basis of which the presidential order to create the Department of Cooperation was passed, it was suggested that these two bodies should be administered separately, and that is why we have now come before Parliament with this National Cooperative Development Corporation Bill. The other bill relating to the Warehousing Corporation will come up through the Ministry of Food and Agriculture after the bill is passed. Therefore, sir, the present bill is only an amending bill, and opportunity has been taken to have some minor amendment made in the bill. Firstly, the original act covered only agricultural produce, and agricultural produce had been defined in that act. Now, besides agricultural produce, any notified commodity is also being included. If government wants to include any commodity for which Parliament is competent to legislate, it can notify that commodity and apply the provision of this measure to that commodity. In that case, we will not have to come to Parliament again and again. Any commodity which is in concurrent list and for which Parliament can legislate can be notified by government for application of these provisions. The second amendment is about the functional committee. In the present act, there is no provision for functional committees. Now, this corporation has to deal with credit, processing, marketing, consumer and all these types of item in order to boost up the cooperative movement. We found that there was a lacuna, and therefore we have suggested a provision to have functional committees. It is only an enabling provision, and after this bill becomes act, we will have functional committees regarding credit, processing, consumer, etc. Then there was no power of delegation. Thank you. Please subscribe my channel Steno Star.